last week, we spoke about Jesus' appearance to the disciples, and we spoke about faith. And today's gospel reiterated that theme. We talked about the fact that there was a continuum between doubt and faith, and this is normalized in this passage from Luke. He showed them his hands and his feet. Now think about this. While in their joy, they were disbelieving and still wondering. Jesus declares the why of his journey for the repentance and forgiveness of sins. Humanity was never going to get it right on its own. We always come up short, and God forgives us for this. Think about what a freeing notion that is. So today, I want to focus on the letter from 1 John about who we are. See what the Father has given us, that we are called children of God. I bet that wouldn't be the first way that you'd think to describe yourself. You'd think of your identity, your name, your role of a father, I'm a mason, I'm a mother, I'm a sister, I'm a church member. Is the first thing you're going to think of that you're a child of God? And if you do, how would that change your life? Because when I think of myself as a child of God, I behave better. I bet you would too. I think about what God might want this world to look like. I think about what are the long-term actions and consequences of what I say and what I do. I think about whether I'm being kind and generous and loving. I think about whether I want to yell at the guy who just cut me off on the highway. Or I want to think about maybe he's rushing to a loved one in an emergency room and that God would bless him or her in whatever circumstance they find themselves. I'm in the process of preparing for a boundary awareness training through the Massachusetts Conference. And so I had an article I had to read this week. And it talked about identity. And it was perfect with this week's scripture. They write, in every moment, your identity is the indelible fact that you are a beloved child of God. This is not limited in any way by time or place. That's what and who you are, beloved children. I also looked up 1 John 3, verses 2 to 3 in the Message, which is a more contemporary rendering of the Bible that goes back to the original Hebrew. And I like the variations, so this is verses 2 and 3 again. But friends, that's exactly who you are, children of God. And that's only the beginning. Who knows how we'll end up? What we know is that when Christ is openly revealed, we'll see him, and in seeing him, become like him. All of us who look forward to his coming, stay ready, with the glistening purity of Jesus' life as a model for our own. I love that last line. With the glistening purity of Jesus' life as a model for our own. What do we learn from Jesus as a model for our behavior? First, and I mean, this is how I thought of it, they're really not right. But to be in prayer with a desire to do God's will. When I think of myself as a child of God and just not Diane Dugan or a mom or a pastor, I think about what does God want for my life and my world. I want all of you to think of that. What is your life on this earth? Mine is no better or worse than yours, no more special. We are all ministers. Jesus also teaches us to stay centered. Claim your identity. Don't kind of be blown by the wind back and forth. Figure out who you are, what you believe. Test it out in the congregation. Test it out with the scriptures. Test it out with your experience. And don't be blown by every wind and every doctrine and every news report, every Facebook comment that comes your way. Stay centered. Stay centered thinking of the Holy Spirit inspiring you. Take time for Sabbath. Time for rest, relaxation, and time to deepen your relationship with God. We run on such a crazy schedule in our lives. We go from A to B to C to Z. And sometimes we don't even take time to breathe. Take time for Sabbath. And also, think about Jesus. He took time for self-care, which is the spiritual and embodied kindness toward oneself. Think about it. Spiritual and embodied kindness toward yourself is what self-care is. It means having good boundaries. It means saying no when you shouldn't be doing it. It means not taking on everybody else's drama and allowing it to ruin your mood. Jesus says we are to love one another as you love yourself in Matthew, Mark, and Luke. Loving yourself first is not being selfish. It's being for the self and listening to God, who God created you to be, who God empowers you to be, who God is calling you to be. Once you take care of yourself and keep good boundaries, then you are much better able to take care of anyone. And you are more calm and centered presence in this world. Jesus taught us to stand up for those who are vulnerable, whether victims of chemical attacks, victims of poverty, homelessness, racial discrimination, sexual orientation. Jesus taught us to take care of the widowed, the orphaned, and the oppressed. How many times is that in the Bible? With everything we've been given, we are blessed, whether we have a voice or not. With everything given, we've been given, we are blessed, even with our challenges, even with our histories, even when they haven't been optimal, or what we would have liked. And the last thing that I thought of to give you today is that we need to claim God's love and the forgiveness of our sins. Sin is defined as anything that separates from God. When I'm being angry or persnickety or ill-tempered, am I in line with God? No. And it doesn't mean we're going to do it perfectly. Remember, that's what Jesus says. That's why I came. Because you weren't going to get